Hi, I'm Alan Mildren and been filming underwater around the coast of Britain for nearly 40 years. The story of Tales from Sandy Bottom, where did that all start from?
Tales from Sandy Bottom. Down on the seabed at Sandy Bottom live a group of animals. Dermot the hermit crab, Crunch the swimming crab, Sandy the mud runner crab, Eddie the edible crab, Squatty the squat lobster, and Larry the lobster.
Well, I'm going to tell you, it must have been back now 20 years ago, and in those days I was making slide projection sequences using four projectors that were controlled by computers. And I thought it might be a good idea to make a small, short, 5-minute long children's sequence about a couple of crabs crawling around the seabed, looking at the problems that their friends were having on the seabed. And at that time, I'd been asked to do a show up in London, one of the dive shows at Olympia, and that must have been about 1998. I was one of the speakers that year, and I thought it might be a good place to show it. And a lecturer, Dr. Caroline Heaps from Bournemouth University, asked if I'd be interested in speaking to them about the sequence and to show it to them. They were doing something on children's education and using the seashore as a basis for that. Anyway, the show lay dormant for a number of years, and it was only when my granddaughter Ophelia was born and I started watching a lot of children's TV with her, of which most of them were animated shows, that I started thinking about that crab sequence that I made that many years ago. So I ended up writing four environmental stories about these group of crabs going around the seabed at Sandy Bottom. The first film in the series, the Tales from Julie Jewel and Anemone, was finished. Most of it was filmed down at Babbercombe Bay, and this was where I made the film The Cuttlefish of Babbercombe Bay. Copies still available from my website. Anyway, when it was finally finished, I sent it off to various TV channels, but all they wanted were animated stuff, and they did have a look at it, but I say it was, this is what children are watching now, not real animals running around the seabed. That was that, I thought. Anyway, a bit later on, while looking out to the window one wet morning, I thought, why not see if I can get it published? The stories and the pictures are all there. All I needed to do is find a publisher. And would you believe the first publisher I tried, W.H. Stockwell's, said yes. It did take about 3 months before they came back to me. Apparently they give it out to readers to make sure it was suitable for their publication. They've been going about 130 years now, so they're well-established publishers. So there you have it. It's out there now in Amazon, in Waterstones, in various other bookshops. If you do have problems trying to get hold of it, if you go to my website and drop me a line, I can furnish you with a copy. Eventually I will put it out on my website to buy it direct. So happy reading, kids.
With their fishing nets and go off for some ice cream. Did they notice the problem in the rock pool? So, children, always take your rubbish home with you and never ever leave it to blow into the sea.